Dear friends and relatives, Antisetsileno. My name is Morgan Guerin. I'm a member of the Musqueam First Nation. My ancestral name is Setsileno. It's my honor to be here to share a few words with you as you embark onto the next stage of your life. These moments to our Coast Salish people, our Hwalmuk people, my people, the Musqueam people, are so very important. They are usually draped and honored in ceremony. The transition of your old life to your new life. And it is really indeed my honor to be here to share a few words with you today, welcoming you to this new part of your life. So we've overcome over the last year new changes, changes which we thought would be temporary, but we found out very quickly weren't. But there was a good reminder of the way that the river of life flows. There are some times you need to paddle a little bit harder to get to where you need to go. And you honor those moments, those challenges, as they're part of you. They're part of your being and who you are as you move on to this next part of your life. So I welcome you as you step off the blanket from who you were to who you are now, this transition. Honor this moment. Be grateful for it. As you move from the beginning of your education to either your next part of your education or your next walk in life, whatever you have chosen, make it a good path because it's your path. So it's an honor to be here to share a few words with you. Love yourself on this path as well. You are loved, you are respected. And to no one else, make sure it's from yourself first. These are the teachings of my elders. On behalf of the Musqueam people, I welcome you to our traditional and unceded territory as you walk on this path. I'd like to honor my relatives from the Squamish Tsleil-Waututh as well, whose ancestors also belong to this land. Three nations, once divided by boundaries, but have always been united by bloodlines. On behalf of our people, we welcome you. Haitsepka, Haitsepka, welcome.
Tanzi, good day. My name is Chaz Desjolais, and I am the District Principal of Indigenous Education with the Vancouver School Board. I am member to the Cold Lake First Nations. I'm a Treaty 6 Iskwe. My traditional name is Kaminisuwat, Pisuwat. I am the daughter of Robert Edmund Desjolais, Niheo Métis, and the daughter of Diane Lorraine Johnson, whose lineages is English, French, and Spanish. I'm very grateful to be able to share a few words with everyone today about their accomplishments of their future graduation. I am very grateful for all the students and your commitment and dedication to continuing your education to this point. We know it has been a very, very tough journey, being disconnected from your classmates and not being able to celebrate as you traditionally would. With that, we just want to acknowledge and honor this significant achievement for all students. I would like to share a song with you, which has been gifted to the public by Elder Jerry Ullman of the Stiatmik Nation. This song is called the Gathering Strength Song. I think it is appropriate at this time, as you will need to continue to gather strength as you move on to your next journey of your life, whether it be education, careers, or maybe perhaps taking a break. This song, I hope, will bring you journey as you move forward. That brings you some additional strength as you continue on, as you move forward in this time. And I would additionally like to say thank you to your families, your communities, and/or nations that you come from. I know that everybody has been wrapped around you with love and support during this process, and I wish you the best as you continue your life journey, educational journey, and as you continue to move forward. Pacheco.
Greetings to the class of 2021. I'm honored to celebrate this special day with you. I'm grateful that we can gather on the unceded traditional territory of the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh peoples. 2 years ago, I gave a similar speech to the grad class of 2019. I spoke about our paths coming together, diverging again, and leaving behind our own unique stories and memories, our legacies. It seems prescient now, looking back. COVID-19 has left quite the legacy. You'll be the first graduating class to have spent the entire school year under pandemic restrictions. You will feel the educational and emotional impacts for years to come. We all will. But you're not the first graduating class to survive a pandemic. Back in 1918, the conditions were not dissimilar. There were unknowns in medicine, horrific death toll, new habits and routines that were designed to keep people safe, but feel so foreign to the people of the time. You may have family members who survived it and have shared their stories and memories with you. We've all learned a lot about medicine and public health and much more besides. The full lessons of the current pandemic won't be totally clear for many years to come. But I wonder what lessons you've already learned. I've learned that I miss hugs, I hate Zoom meetings, and that I could get better at asking for help. I've learned that our economic and social systems are very fragile, and that in many cases, they were already broken even before the pandemic hit. I learned that there will be a lot of uncertainty, and if we're gonna make it, we're gonna have to get comfortable with uncertainty. It might feel daunting or bleak. It might feel like no one else can ever possibly understand what you're going through. Try to resist that thought. Try to lean on your family, your friends, your teachers, the families of your choosing. Let them lean on you. Share your resources and your resourcefulness. Find strength and wisdom in the stories and memories of your elders. Be generous with your gifts and your passions, but also be ready to accept them when they're offered to you. Which brings me to the parents, grandparents, and family members. Thank you for bestowing your gifts, your stories, your memories upon these students. Thank you for your words of encouragement, for holding their hands on the first day of school, and for sharing their joys and their sorrows. To the administrators and staff at Gladstone Secondary, thank you for your commitment, your sweat, your tears, your love. These kids might not realize it, but you're a big reason why they're here today. Thank you for being there when they needed you. To the graduates, today we celebrate your successes and look to the future. It's probably not going to be easy, but if you look after one another, you're going to be just fine, and the world will be better for it. So on behalf of the district, congratulations, good luck, and don't forget to love each other.
My name is Suzanne Hoffman, and I am the superintendent of schools. And I want to start by sincerely congratulating the graduates of 2021. I want to start by welcoming all of you to this virtual convening, and I want to welcome our parents, our families, our friends, the staff that have joined the convening, and of course, the graduates of 2021. I want to start by acknowledging the sense of loss that I think has been felt by so many of our students over the course of this year, particularly so for those that are graduating. The fact that you haven't been able to engage in clubs, extracurricular activities with your peers in a very social way, I think is a loss for all of you. And I acknowledge that this has been a year like no other. And as we go forward, I'm reminded of the things that have come about in a positive and good way. A Killarney student that I was speaking to this year spoke about school as so much more than just an educational institution. And the fact that the social nature of our world is really of paramount importance to our students. A student from Point Grey reminded me how much you've had to adapt and how much you've had to overcome. And for all of the perseverance, the diligence, the hard work that you have put into this school year, I want to recognize that, and I want to thank you for all that you have done to get to the point that you are as a graduate. Brené Brown is an author, and she speaks about life and how we transition through the phases of life. And as you think about your next phase, she talks about stepping into the arena. She talks about daring greatly and being brave. And as you look ahead in your life, I would encourage you to step into your own personal arenas. In thinking of big arenas, I think of Amanda Gorman. And she was the youngest poet laureate to ever have that title. And she stepped into an arena at the presidential election. And at that time, she shook the world. Her diminutive stature was so evident, but it was overtaken by her poise, her prose, and her presence. And she delivered such a powerful speech that was inspiring to so many. And she described herself, when we think of overcoming adversity, as someone who was a weird child. She had a speech impediment. She had an auditory processing disorder. And yet she worked to overcome the adversity and stepped into a world stage arena. Gandhi says to gently shake the world. And I would encourage each and every one of you as you contemplate the next phase of your life to go forward and make positive differences in the lives of others. Together, we can make the world a better place. And as graduates, the world lies ahead of you to make that the case for each and every one of you. I want to sincerely congratulate you on your graduation. I wish you the very best of everything in the days, the months, and the years ahead. Congratulations, graduates.
Hi, my name is Lisa Pacheco, and I am the counselor of the Gladstone graduates of 2021. Please join me in acknowledging that we live, work, and learn on the unceded traditional lands of the Musqueam, Tsleil-Waututh, and Squamish Coast Salish peoples. Today, it is my privilege to pay tribute to the graduates of 2021, a group of grads that embodies tenacity and resilience. In grade 8, you entered the auditorium wide-eyed, eager, and nervous about your new life at Gladstone. Back then, there were questions about the future of Gladstone and discussions of closure. You persevered through the adolescent ups and downs of grades 8 to 10, only to see the light at the end of the tunnel give way to a global pandemic. Your education has been flanked by extreme elements beyond your control, but you took it in stride, and your resilience and adaptability armed you with strength and with courage. Your caring helped you to sustain each other at the most challenging times. You wore masks to keep yourselves and others safe. You Instagrammed and TikToked to stay connected. You were kind, compassionate, and gentle with each other as we navigated a foreign school life on teams and in quarters. You are now young adults, ready to leave these familiar halls for a larger world full of limitless challenges and possibilities. Today, you cross the stage, receive your diploma, and take your first steps on your individual journeys with this final pause to celebrate the entirely unique Gladstone graduating class of 2021. You have shared laughter, your sense of humor, and your passion for life have been inspiring. Whether showing off a sassy dance move or duct taping a banana for spy versus spy protection, the joy seems to come easily because you have grown to trust each other. The laughter in the hallways, and at times your sheer silliness, has really brightened our days. You have shared accomplishments. We celebrate your achievements, the academic challenges that you have tackled, the offers of admission to post-secondary, the scholarships, the activities you have planned and participated in, the volunteer work you have done in the school and in the community, the teams you have played on, the clubs you have joined, the robots that you have built and rebuilt, the food you have prepared, and the music, dance, and theatrical performances you have excelled in. Collectively and individually, you should be so proud. I must confess that it took me a long time to compose this speech. I found it truly challenging to try to capture in words the honor that I have felt to be part of your lives. I would like to thank you for enriching my life. You generously opened your hearts and allowed me to be part of your journey. You shared your struggles, your hopes, and your dreams with me, and it has been my sincerest privilege to have had the opportunity to be part of your lives. Grads of 2021, you are now entering a complicated world, and not just because of unprecedented advanced technology and globalization, but also because your generation demands that we do better than we have done before. Your generation demands that we challenge established norms, that we acknowledge those that came before us and how they were treated, and that we hold those examples high as cautionary tales, never to be repeated, and that demands better of all of us. That we do not accept things simply because they are, but that we mindfully and thoughtfully construct a world in which everyone has the opportunity to live a life free from arbitrary limits based on gender, race, orientation, or economic status. You care about the earth in ways that may just save it. You teach us that mistakes of the past are not roadmaps for the future. You are the generation tasked with rewriting humanity's script. Some may call it being woke. Some of you may dismiss it as cancel culture. Some may regard your values as just another fleeting trend. But I know that you will not quit. You have shown a tenacity capable of making the world an inclusive place and have the creativity to manifest the vision. Nelson Mandela said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." Grads of 2021, take all your knowledge and skill and transform the planet. My wish for all of you is to seize the future and move forward with a strong resolve to achieve your aspirations and in turn make your mark. Take advantage of the possibilities, challenge yourself to achieve your goals, and always be the best version of yourself. Armed with your hopes and dreams, embrace the future and make it better for all of us. If anyone can, it is you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Gladstone Grad of 2021.
Thank you.
JJ Bones. JJ is a fan of sports. He's been through a lot of tough things, but he's come out on top. He's looking forward to the GPS program next year. JJ has been awarded the Gladstone Life Skills Achievement Award. Jaden Hundel. Jaden would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for all the support and encouragement they provided throughout his time at Gladstone. A special shout out to his friends, JJ and Carrie, for all their support. Aaron Lee. Aaron would like to thank all his teachers and plans to attend college. Aaron has been awarded the Gladstone Life Skills Achievement Award. Chloe Rohali. Chloe is grateful for all her Gladstone teachers. She especially would like to thank Bill Dizzy and the entire Life Skills staff for helping her make her feel happy and proud. Chloe plans to save money for Disneyland this summer and will be attending the GTA program in the fall. Abrar Youssef. Abrar wants to thank his teachers and his family for supporting him throughout the years. Andre Abad. Andre is known for rigging, animating, and plans on studying digital arts. Erica Chiaki Aguilar. Erica would like to thank everyone that helped her through this adventure. She hopes to attend SFU and study criminology. Erica has been awarded the Universal Buddhist Temple Award. Hi. Thank you. Nicole Alelis. Nicole would like to show her appreciation and will always cherish all the support she has received from her friends, family, and teachers at Gladstone. She plans on attending Douglas College to study nursing. Angel Alvarado. Angel says he caused a lot of trouble and he didn't think he would make it this far. He plans to do something in the future. Juca Farma Alvarina. Farah is an ambitious person who is grateful for her supporting family. She intends to study nursing and become an entrepreneur in the future. Farah has been nominated for a district scholarship. Juca Murfa Alvarina. Mara is a sedulous person who also loves singing. She plans to pursue nursing at Langara and travel the world with her family. Mara has been nominated for a district scholarship. Sarah Amiri. Sarah would like to say that today is amazing, despite the challenges of missing her family, wishing they were here. A huge thank you to her mom, dad, and teachers for helping her get here. Sarah has won the Newcomer Welcome Center Scholarship. Sh- Sean Arellano. Sean would like to thank his family for supporting him throughout the years. He would like to pursue being a mechanic after grad and joining the reserves. Sean has been awarded the Culinary Arts Training Grant. Selah would like to thank all friends and family who stuck with her until this point and wishes them all good luck. Binja Bagadabanga. Binja would like to thank everyone who took part in their education and mental development to this part of their life. Tate Barr. Tate would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Lovely Bernalis. Lovely would like to thank her family and friends and school staff for helping and supporting her throughout the years. Vanshika Bami. Vanshika would like to thank her family for their support. She looks forward to attending the GPS program next year and time with her family. Jobin Bhatti. Jobin plans to attend Langara College to study nursing. Will Budnaris. Will was a part of the Dungeons and Dragons Club and would like to thank Mr. Parks for all the great poker lessons at lunch. Shayla Brown. Shayla would like to acknowledge that she couldn't have done it without her mom. Thanks, Mom. She is being awarded the Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement and the District Principal Award in Leadership and Excellence. Kizzy May Theodore Kakabi. Kizzy would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her throughout her high school career. She plans to attend Langara to study Bachelor's of Business Administration. Good. Jada Kai. Jada would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Jada has been awarded the Rotary Stay in School Scholarship. Justin Cam. Justin would like to thank everyone as he couldn't have graduated without everyone's effort. Toby Campbell. Toby would like to say that ska came before reggae. Toby was selected as one of two Indigenous valedictorians in the district and has been awarded the District Principal Award in Leadership and Excellence and receives an Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement. Congratulations, Toby. Justin Andre Kamengal. Justin would like to thank his family and friends for their support and plans to study aircraft maintenance engineering at BCIT. Melody Cow. Melody thanks her friends, family, and teachers for all the support during her time at Gladstone. Lorelei Sen. Lorelei would like to thank everyone who helped her through her high school years. Kyle Chan. Kyle would like to give a thanks to all the teachers who have helped him improve and progress throughout his time here. Isabel Chang. Despite all her stress and injuries, Isabel is grateful for everyone who has supported her and helped her make these past 5 years memorable. Isabel has been awarded the Rotary Stay in School Scholarship and is nominated for a district scholarship. She has also won the Top Dance 12 Book Award, Chemistry 12 Book Award, and the Outstanding Achievement in Explorations 11 Award. Congratulations, Isabel. Rachel Chow. Rachel will miss being at Gladstone. However, she's looking forward to studying applied sciences at SFU in the fall. She wishes everyone all the best. Rachel has won the D.B. McKenzie Award and the Paul Wallace Memorial Scholarship. She has also been nominated for a district scholarship. She has also been awarded the Top Art 12 Book Award and the Outstanding Achievement in Law 12 Award. Congratulations, Rachel. Oscar Chark. Oscar would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Kaylan Chow. Kaylan was the co-leader of the lighting crew and plans to get her red seal in baking and pastry arts. Alan Chen. Alan was a member of the robotics team and basketball team and plans to attend UBC to study engineering. Alan is the winner of the Governor General's Academic Medal, which is the school's highest academic award. He is also the recipient of the R.C. Thomas Scholarship and has been nominated for a district scholarship. He has also won the Outstanding Achievement in Physical Geography Award. Congratulations, Alan. Jesse Chen. Jesse would like to thank those who have made high school enjoyable. Richard Chen. Richard would like to thank everyone who has supported him. He plans to take accounting at BCIT. Callie Chang. Callie ended up at Gladstone because of a mistake. However, she hopes the next mistakes in her future will be as fulfilling as this one. Callie has won the Wason Choi Memorial Scholarship and has been nominated for a district scholarship. She is also the winner of the Top Creative Writing 12 Student Book Award. Congratulations, Callie. Sarah Chow. Sarah would like to thank her family and friends for helping her get through the years. She is excited to attend BCIT in the future. She is the recipient of the Beaconsfield Elementary School Scholarship. Aiden Christensen. Aiden would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Felicia Chung. Felicia thanks her family, friends, and the teachers who supported her throughout high school. Felicia will be attending UBC in the fall. Felicia has won the Adrian Dix Award. Kyra Coligado. Kyra will study business at UVic and would like to quote Hannah Montana as she says, "Life's the climb, but the view is great." Kyra has been nominated for a district scholarship and has won the top grade 12 Spanish student award. Angeline Como. Angeline appreciates her family and most importantly God for guiding her throughout her years in school and her friends for making it all worthwhile. She is striving to become a phlebotomist after high school. Serenity Crocker. Serenity would like to thank her grandma for forcing her to go to high school and to finish. She looks forward to visiting family in Prince George. Serenity is receiving the Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement. Francis Cruz. Francis would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for being with him along this journey. He plans to pursue pursue fashion in the future. Francis has been awarded the Athletic Leadership Book Award. Lucas de Conceição do Nascimento. Lucas really liked metalwork and woodwork classes. He intends to work in this area in the future. Ming Dai Tang. Ming has learned that one person can really make a difference. Ming will never forget his parents' care and love and hopes that they will always be happy and healthy. James Dang. James is grateful to graduate this year and thanks those who have helped him and given him the opportunity to access the wonderful culture in Canada. He appreciates how welcoming everyone was. Adrian de Guzman. Adrian wants to thank his teachers, friends, and family and is now planning to attend UBC this fall. Adrian has been awarded the Outstanding Achievement in Explorations 11 Award. Ashley Dio. Ashley would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Alicia Dhaliwal. Alicia would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Alicia has been awarded the Outstanding Achievement in Law Award. Jaskarn Dillon. Jaskarn would like to thank everyone who made his high school experience memorable. Elisa Deidre. Elisa would like to thank her friends for the good times and thanks her family for all the support. Whatever her future holds, it will be devoted to helping others. Kwe Do. Kwe would like to thank her teachers for guiding her throughout the years. She plans to attend UBC to study science. Kwe has been nominated for a district scholarship. Nicholas Doan. Nicholas would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Leanne Drakes. Leanne is grateful to her teachers, friends, and family for always supporting her throughout high school. Leanne enjoyed being on the volleyball team, student council, and the dance team. Leanne has won the Norquay Elementary School PAC scholarship. Neve Elam. Neve thanks everyone that helped him. He was an avid member of Gladstone's community and plans to attend UBC. Peace out, says Neve. Neve has won the Karen Till Scholarship and the VZ Scholarship Nominee Award, as well as the Michael C. Savage Memorial Scholarship. Neve has also been awarded the Math Book Award and the Top Grade 12 French Student Award. Congratulations, Neve. Abby Flores. Abby wants to thank her family and friends for staying with her throughout high school. Her plan is to study nursing or tourism after a year. Patrick Fung. Patrick would like to thank his family and staff at Gladstone for the guidance he has received throughout the years. Patrick plans to attend BCIT to study trades discovery after graduation. Manveer Gandhi. Manveer would like to thank his friends and family for the support they have given him throughout high school. Amelia Gent. Amelia would like to thank her family, best friend, and favorite teachers for getting her through high school. Amelia is very excited to move to Victoria in the summer. Amelia has been nominated for a district scholarship. Bernadette Junanga. Bernadette is grateful to her parents for their loving support and her friends for making school entertaining. She plans to continue her studies at Langara to become a nurse. Bernadette has won the Grad Class of 1978 Scholarship Award. Eugene Gomez. Eugene, unsure of his path after today, is aiming towards entering service for his community and country. He would like to thank everyone for treating him well. Natalia Gonzalez. Natalia was part of the senior girls soccer team, as well as the co-ed futsal team, and plans to study psychology at UBC. Natalia has won the Grad Class of 1988 Bursary Award. Michelle Guevara. Michelle would like to thank her friends and family for all their love and support. She plans to pursue a career in makeup artistry. Nicholas Gunbone. Nicholas would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Nicholas will receive the Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement. Alicia Ha. Alicia would like to thank her family for supporting her through her journey. She plans to attend UBC in order to pursue a law degree. Zian Haynes. Zian says that he was an interesting student. He plans to study kinesiology. Sapphire Hoyle. Sapphire would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Kinwa Wu. Jackson was an international student and wants to thank his family for giving him these opportunities, and thanks school staff and his friends for supporting him. Brian Huang. Brian would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Jordan Huang. Jordan would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for all their support. He plans on attending UBC to study applied sciences and engineering. Jordan is the winner of the C.K. Huscroft Scholarship. Elizabeth Nguyen. Liz wants to thank her friends, family, and teachers who helped her during high school. She plans to attend SFU and sail the seas. Liz has been nominated for a district scholarship. Gordon Nguyen. Gordon would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for their support through his years at Gladstone. He plans to attend SFU in the fall to study engineering. Gordon has won the Cunningham Elementary School PAC Scholarship. Walter Nguyen. Walter was a goal-driven student and plans to attend SFU to study kinesiology. He thanks his friends, family, and teachers for their support. Walter has won the Top Strength and Conditioning Book Award. Mohamed Iwanasofa. Mohamed would like to thank his family, teachers, and friends for assisting him during his high school years. Next year, he'll be going to Langara to pursue health sciences. Justine Jang. Justine would like to thank her parents, teachers, and the friends she made during her high school years. Shay Jarvis. Shay would like to thank his teachers for the last 5 years at Gladstone. He looks forward to watching hockey now. Kannan Jayakumar. Kannan would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for always giving all their support throughout his years at Gladstone. He plans to attend SFU for computer engineering this fall. Kannan has been nominated for a district scholarship. Ram Jayankumar. Ram would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for always giving their unconditional support. He plans to attend UBC for computer science. Ram has won the Marion Dedier Memorial Leadership Award, as well as the VZ Scholarship Nominee Award. Ram has also been nominated for a district scholarship. Congratulations, Ram. Dominic Johnson. Dominic was involved in many sports at Gladstone and will attend SFU for business. He thanks his friends and family for making his high school experience a good one. Dominic has won the Grad Class of 1976 Scholarship Award and the Active Living 12 Book Award. Megan Jones. Megan would like to thank her family and teachers for all the support they gave her during her time at Gladstone. Megan will receive the Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement. Miriam Kazi. Miriam would like to thank her friends and family for sticking around and hopes everyone will have a happy future going forward. Wolfgang Kesting. Wolfgang thanks his family, friends, and teachers for their support on his high school journey. Stephen Kong. Stephen was a member of the basketball team and plans to attend VCC to study cooking. Kai Corum. Kai would like to thank his family, teachers, and friends for supporting him through his time at Gladstone. He plans to attend SFU's engineering program. Kai has won the Larry Killick Memorial Scholarship. Tiffany Kong. Tiffany plans on studying behavioral neuroscience and would like to thank her friends and family for all their support through high school. Tiffany has won the Rotary Stay in School Scholarship. B.M. Kappa. B.M. thanks her family, friends, and teachers for supporting her throughout her education. She plans to have a career in graphic design. Karen Kwong. Karen would like to thank her friends and teachers for all their support. She plans on attending post-secondary in the fall. Karen has won the Artuna Award and the Outstanding Achievement in Law 12 Award. Navdeep Kular. Navdeep would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Who's this now, Lisa? Nathan Kung. Nathan would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Nathan has been awarded the Culinary Arts Training Grant. Thank you. Amy La. Amy would like to thank her friends for making high school fun. Her future plans include attending post-secondary. Amy has won the VASA Scholarship and has also been awarded the Outstanding Achievement in Explorations 11 Award. Denny Lai. Denny would like to thank his friends and family for helping him during his high school years. Next year, he'll be going to BCIT to pursue mechanics. Go, Hannah Lai. Hannah would like to thank her parents and teachers for supporting her. She plans to go to SFU. Hannah has won the Outstanding Achievement in Physical Geography Award. Janelle Lamb. Janelle would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Sydney Lamb. Sydney would like to thank her family and friends for showing her endless love and support all throughout her high school years. Sydney has won the Alexandra Foundation Bursary and has been nominated for a district scholarship. She's also won an Outstanding Achievement in Comparative Cultures 12 Award. Mark Lamban. Mark would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for the great memories. He plans to pursue nursing at Langara. Mark has won the Beaconsfield Elementary School PAC Scholarship. Ricky Lau. Ricky would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Eunice Laza. Eunice believes that all their hardship will be paid off when they can finally say, "We made it." Eunice would like to thank everyone for helping them reach the finish line. Anthony Lee. Anthony would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Crystal Lee. Crystal would like to thank her family and friends for all the support given during her time at Gladstone. Jericho Legaspi. Jericho would like to thank their friends, family, teachers, and staff who supported them throughout their high school years. They will be taking automotive at BCIT.
Hello, how are you?
Koby Leung. Koby was part of student council and played on the basketball team throughout high school. He thanks his family and friends for always supporting him. Koby is the valedictorian for this year's graduating class. Congratulations, Koby. Oshra Levy-Beck. Oshra has only been at Gladstone since September 2019 and plans to study creative writing at Concordia University once life starts getting back to normal. Kelvin Lee. Kelvin would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Victoria Lee. Victoria will be attending SFU to study business, and like the Backyardians always said, that was an excellent adventure, don't you think? Victoria has won the Vancouver Dodgeball League Sports and Leadership Award. Yvonne Lee. Yvonne was the international representative of student council. She is going to attend the University of Arts London to pursue her fashion dream. Chantille Leanne. Chantille is appreciative of all the support she's received from both her friends and staff at Gladstone. She plans to study criminology and psychology at SFU to one day pursue a law degree. Chantille has been selected as a recipient of the 2021 Eric Ming Community Hero Scholarship, the Sofia Sagrado Scholarship, and the Marion Dedier Memorial Leadership Award. She has also won the Outstanding Achievement in Law 12 and Biology 12 Book Award and the Athletic Leadership Book Award. Congratulations, Chantil. Tammy Liang. Tammy wants to thank her family, friends, and teachers for making her a little less clueless about the world and always pushing her to do her best. She is receiving the Adrian Dix Award and the Alexandra Foundation Award and is also nominated for a district scholarship. Ty Lim. Ty would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during this time at Gladstone. Michelle Lynn. Michelle would like to thank her friends, family, and staff for their support and kindness and plans to study interactive arts and technology. She is receiving the Universal Buddhist Temple Award. Amy Ling. Amy would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Audria Liu. Audria wants to thank everyone who helped her. She plans to attend UBC to study dinosaurs. She is receiving the Grad Class of 1977 Achievement Award. Vinto Liu. Vinto would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Ryan Lowe. Ryan would like to thank his family for their love and support. He looks forward to attending the GPS program next year. He is receiving the Developmental Disabilities Association Scholarship Award. Vivian Liu. Vivian would like to thank her family, friends, and Gladstone staff for the past 5 years. Jessica Lum. Jessica would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for getting her through high school years. Jessica will be attending VCC. Penelope Lumendez. Penelope would like to thank her family, friends, and mentors for supporting her when she needed it most. Penelope will be studying social work at Langara and transferred to UBC for a bachelor's degree. She is the recipient of the Universal Buddhist Temple Award. Vian Luong. Vian would like to thank her teachers, peers, and her family for everything. She is planning to attend BCIT and obtain a diploma in graphic communications. Vianne is the winner of the Sofia Sagrado Scholarship and the Alexandra Foundation Award. Nicholas Ma. Nicholas would like to thank everyone who has supported him and plans to attend SFU to study sciences. Nicholas is receiving the Paul Wallace Memorial Scholarship. Jefferson Angelo Madera. Jefferson Angelo would like to thank his parents for being patient with him. He will try his best in the military. Jeff Moore Angelo Madera. Jeff Morangelo would like to thank his family and school staff for being patient with him. He will do his best to become an auto mechanic. Miriam Mahmoud. Miriam would like to thank her teachers, family, and friends for all the support. She plans to attend UBC to pursue the arts. She's receiving the Outstanding Achievement in Comparative Cultures 12 Award. Janice Mai. Janice would like to thank all of her family and the school staff who supported her throughout the years. June Malzuski. June would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Anmol Mander. Anmol would like to thank his friends, family, and the staff for supporting him throughout high school. He will be pursuing a business degree at KPU this September. Mark Maneja. Mark would like to thank his friends and family for supporting him throughout his high school years. Sho Matsuda. Sho wishes everyone the best. Sunny McMillan. Sunny would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Agatha Millie. Agatha would like to thank her teachers, parents, and her friends for helping her make the most of her time at Gladstone. Agatha will be attending the University of Alberta to study engineering. She is the winner of the Barbara G. Baker Scholarship and the Outstanding Achievement in Law 12 Award. Congratulations, Agatha. Cherry Moe. Cherry plans to attend UBC to study arts. She is the winner of the Vancouver Hannon Church Award and the Outstanding Achievement in Law 12 Award. Farhan Mohammed. Farhan would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Francesca Mondiglio. Francesca would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Deshaun Newman. Deshaun looks forward to attending the VSB Extended Program next year and building his resume with work experience. Deshaun is receiving the Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement. Katie No. Katie would like to thank all of Gladstone's staff and students who have made great contributions to the school community. She looks forward to studying at FIC to study contemporary art. Annie Nguyen. Annie would like to thank her family and friends for being supportive. She plans to study psychology in post-secondary. Darlene Nguyen. Darlene says it has been a wonderful opportunity to meet all the staff and administrators at this school and thanks them for being a part of her education journey. She is receiving the Gladstone PAC Bursary and the Bob Fitzpatrick Outstanding Student Award. Dong Nguyen. Dong would like to say thank you to everyone he's met at Gladstone. Next year, he'll be going to BCIT to pursue business. Helen Nguyen. Helen would like to thank her friends and family for their support. She plans to pursue a career in nursing. Henry Nguyen. Henry would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Jia Hui Nguyen. Jia Hui would like to thank his family for always being there for him and his teachers for being such great friends throughout the year. Jacob Nguyen. Jacob will be attending UBC to acquire a real estate license and plans to become an entrepreneur in the future.
That's James. Who's this one? Oh.
James Nguyen. James was a member of the junior and senior basketball team, grad committee, and plans to attend BCIT to study engineering. Johnny Nguyen. Johnny would like to thank his friends and family for helping him throughout high school and plans to attend Langara for computer science. Zarel Nicholas. Zarel was a good student at Gladstone and plans to attend Langara College to study psychology. Jaden Olson. Jaden would like to thank Amelia for taking her through every mental breakdown this year. Jaden is receiving the Indigenous Education Certificate of Achievement. Ryan Partridge. Ryan would like to thank his teachers and family for their continued support through high school. Abby Pearly. Abby thanks her friends for making her smile every day from grade 8 until graduation. She plans to attend SFU to study interactive arts and technology. Abby is the winner of the Paul Wallace Memorial Scholarship and the Jeff Studell Poetry Scholarship. She is also the recipient of the Michael C. Savage Memorial Scholarship. Wait, Abby. And she is nominated for a district scholarship. She has won one of the VSB Teacher Recognition Scholarships for 2021 and has also been given the Top English Student Book Award. Congratulations, Abby. Zui Ann Pham. Adam plans to attend SFU to study cybersecurity. Hey. Grace Pham. Grace would like to thank everyone who has helped her discover herself and plans to attend Capilano University to study 3D animation. Jason Pham. Jason would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Max Picone. Max would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Parathan Prabhakaran. Parathan would like to thank his friends, family, and staff for helping him complete high school at Gladstone Secondary. Prichelle Raj. Prichelle wants to thank her family, friends, and teachers for all of their support. She plans on pursuing her dream of becoming an occupational therapist starting at Langara College. Zaris Reyes. Zaris would like to thank her family and friends for their continuous love and support throughout the years. She will be studying molecular biology and biochemistry at SFU this fall. Tristine Rio Totar. Tristine would like to thank her family for their continuous support and encouragement, her friends for all the wonderful memories, and her soulmate, Jessica, for late-night calls and friendly banter. Tristine has won the top grade 12 Japanese student award. Eric Robinson. Eric would like to thank his friends and family for the unconditional support they have shown him throughout his journey. Vincent Sam. Vincent will be attending SFU for post-secondary. Jekyll Jade Santiago. Jekyll Jade would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Emma Sinclair. Emma would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Simon Situ. Simon would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Hooplop Sue. Hooplop would like to thank her family and friends for always motivating and being there for her throughout her high school years. She would also like to thank the school staff for making every lesson easier to learn. Hooplop is the winner of the Rotary Stay in School Scholarship. Mathilde Squarcia. Mathilde would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Leanne Sue. Leanne would like to thank her teachers, friends, and family for their unconditional support. She will be attending UBC in the fall to study sciences. Leanne is nominated for a district scholarship. K. Kevin Ta. Kevin would like to thank his mom. Jackie Tang. Jackie would like to thank everyone for the wonderful memories and journeys of the past 5 years. He wishes you all good luck in the future. Kevin Tang. Kevin was a member of the junior soccer team and plans to attend LaSalle College to study culinary arts. He is receiving the Top Strength and Conditioning Book Award. Selena T. Selena would like to give her sincerest thanks to her family, friends, teachers, and coaches. Their love and support over the years means everything to her and more. Selena has won the Coast Capital Savings Award, a community service scholarship, and has also been nominated for a district scholarship. Congratulations, Selena. Van Plasu. Van would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Rajan Tour. Rajan would like to thank his family, friends, and the staff for all the support during his time at Gladstone. Rajan is ecstatic to be attending Vancouver Film School in the fall. Angelina Tran. Angelina is thankful for her time with friends on the robotics team and yearbook committee and aspires to become a forensic biotechnologist. She has won the Rotary State School Scholarship and has also been nominated for a district scholarship. Stephen So. Stephen would like to thank his family and friends and teachers for supporting him throughout his time at Gladstone, and he plans on studying dietetics at UBC. He is the Vancouver Dodgeball League Sports and Leadership Award recipient. Alexandra Valera. Alexandra was co-president of the Student Council and a member of the dance team throughout high school. She plans to attend U of T in the fall to study life sciences. Alexandra has won the Student Council Scholarship and has been nominated for a district scholarship. She is also the recipient of the Grad Class of 1976 Scholarship Award. Congratulations, Alexandra. Antonio Valladares Juarez. Antonio would like to thank Gladstone and his mom and dad for supporting him. He is looking forward to finishing up his auto collision course at VCC and working in the industry. Bernadette Ventura. Bernadette has always been involved in graphic design, dance, and theater. She acknowledges the importance of mental health in our everyday lives and plans to attend Merritt College to study psychiatric nursing. Anthony Vo. Anthony wants to thank the teachers and his friends for helping him to get to where he is today and hopes that he will make you guys proud in the future. He has been nominated for a district scholarship. Caitlin Vo. Caitlin would like to thank her family. She wouldn't be where she is today without their inspiration, support, and guidance. Charlie Vote. Charlie was a member of the Gender Sexuality Alliance, Climate Action Club, and Anti-Racism Coalition this year. They plan on going to Langara to study philosophy. They are the winner of the Top First Peoples English 12 Student Book Award. William Vu. William would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Jennifer Vuong. Jennifer was co-president of Student Council and has graduated from VCC's hairstyling program. She will continue to pursue her career in hairstyling. She has won the Student Council Scholarship and the VCC Education Foundation Entrance Scholarship. Kelly Wong. Kelly would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Mandy Wong. Mandy would like to thank her family and friends and the staff at Gladstone for all the help and support. She plans to attend SFU to study education to become a teacher. Relena Wong. Relena would like to thank the staff members, students, friends, and family for all their support throughout these years. Riley Wong. Riley would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for making high school memorable. He plans to attend BCIT in September. He has won the Grad Class of 1978 Scholarship Award and the Beaconsfield Elementary School PAC Scholarship. Congratulations, Riley. Sheldon Wong. Sheldon would like to thank his family, friends, and the staff of Gladstone for giving him such memorable moments. He plans to attend Langara to study kinesiology. Donna Wu. Before she attends UBC in the fall, Donna would like to thank her teachers for their unwavering support and kindness. Donna is the winner of the VSTA bursary and has been nominated for a district scholarship. She has also won the top grade 12 French student award. Congratulations, Donna. Kenneth Wu. Kenneth wants to thank everyone who has supported him along his journey. He plans to study in the biomedical field for post-secondary. Kenneth has received the Van Zolt Award of Distinction. Lucas Wicca. Lucas is thankful for all of his homies. He plans to pursue acting in TV and film and one day win an Oscar. Andy Yan. Andy says he's a hard worker and a good one, but not at school, sadly. Jaden Yee. Jaden would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her throughout her high school years and wishes her fellow grads a bright future. Sri Hitesh Yenupathala. Sri would like to thank his family, teachers, and friends for helping him reach this stage. He plans to attend SFU next year and study data science. Sri has won the Mabel Shum Memorial Scholarship. Sammy Yoneda. Sammy looks forward to attend SFU to pursue a career in sustainable energy engineering. Sammy has been nominated for a district scholarship and has won the Angus Fraser Award. Lava Youssef. Lava would like to thank her family because they sacrificed so much. She wants to thank all the staff and plans to attend Blanche McDonald College to study global makeup. Lilav Youssef. Lilav would like to thank her family and teachers that were always beside her. She plans to attend VCC to become a dental assistant. Sophia Yu. Sophia would like to thank all her friends, family, and teachers for supporting her throughout high school. She will be attending Simon Fraser University studying sciences. Sophia has been nominated for a district scholarship. Sophia Yu. Sophia would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers. She would like to travel the world. Sophia has been awarded the top grade 12 Spanish student award. Angelo Zeng. Angelo is very grateful to the friends he met at school. He wishes them all good luck in the future. Angelo has been awarded the Culinary Arts Training Grant. Byron Zhu. Byron would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Jessica Hulin Zhao Kai. Jessica Hulin would like to thank their family and teachers for all the support they gave them during their time at Gladstone. Whaley Zhu. Whaley would like to thank his teachers, friends, and family for their amazing help and support. He plans to attend UBC to study science. Whaley has won the Woolsey Bursary. Hugh Zhao. Hugh would like to thank his parents, grandparents, and all the staff at Gladstone who helped him get to where he is today. He hopes this day brings lots of fond memories to the class of 2021. Thank you, everyone. Congratulations to our grads of 2021.
Hey, class of 2021. Who would have thought that 5 years ago, you would be listening to this valedictorian speech on your devices while at home? It feels like yesterday we all wrote those graduate letters to our future selves. This valedictorian speech really reminded me how much our senior class has gone through all together. Before I start my speech, I would like to acknowledge and say thank you to those who have given me the position as valedictorian for the 2021 graduating class. In the beginning, I'll admit, our grade was immature. Some more than others. We're with typical grade eights. Some of us were busy flipping water bottles, some blasting music through the halls, some spent a lot of time roaming the hallways, and some were genuinely studying and working hard. But through it all, many of us shared common memories, from school dances like Maui and Flashback, to the spirit relays and carnivals, to hanging out in spaces in front of our lockers and the grade 8 lounge. While we were known as a chaotic grade, we eventually found our ways, finding our passions, working towards our futures, and becoming leaders. Without our grade, we would not have people in lighting and stage crew, working hard in the background to provide the foundations for those in dance or theater companies to shine in the spotlight. This is a testament to what our grade is capable of. It showcases our ability to see the needs and become the ones who seek leadership opportunities. In our senior year, we were hit hard with a global pandemic that changed everything. Life began to look stale, and all, if not most, of us were trapped inside our own homes in this never-ending cycle. Though we may have initially struggled during this time, we also took advantage of all the free time that we had to discover our passions, whether it involved honing our abilities in video games or even ordering Uber Eats every day. We all found creative and innovative ways to help deal with the pandemic. Personally, for me, I felt extremely isolated and realized how much social interaction people need. Now, in our graduating year as a whole, our class has become calmer and more mature. The contrast of entering high school as these loud, obnoxious grade eights to now a more subdued class in our last year is significant. Even though this year challenged us by being disconnected, we were still able to adapt and find ways to interact with each other, whether that be collaborating together on schoolwork or participating in school events. These interactions kept us connected during the school year. Because of this, I would also like to give our thanks to teachers, administrators, and school staff on behalf of our grade, even the ones who are no longer here. Some of us were taught science by Ms. Moore, but only picked up how to say good luck in 6 different languages. Not only did Mr. Hare teach sports, but he also gave us his wisdom and taught us the importance of teamwork. We were also taught by Ms. Montroy on how to use noodle tools, but there's many of us who still don't know how to use the Library Learning Commons. Overall, the teachers played a big role in shaping us as individuals by teaching us how to respect others, important life skills, and inspiring passions in us, among other lessons. On another note, we would like to thank our counselor, Ms. Pacheco, on behalf of our grade. Thank you for staying with us through our younger years. Thank you for dealing with our never-ending course changes, and thank you for giving us advice whenever we needed it. I'd also like to acknowledge our support systems, whether that be family or friends that had backed us through this chapter of our lives, and to my own family, thank you for being here. These last few weeks made me reflect on our time at Gladstone. We've made friends who we have for a lifetime, who we've shared countless amounts of laughs and tears with, competed with, and who have stayed through thick and thin. Though this was not in any way the year we were expecting, we were able to persevere, coming up with ways to try and make the year more enjoyable. All those quizzes, tests, they all lead us to the apex of our high school careers. Even when faced with huge obstacles, we demonstrated that we have and will always conquer these roadblocks. I have faith in us and all of our abilities, and I am confident we will succeed. Few graduating classes were forced to be as adaptable as ours is, from an uncertain beginning to a bittersweet ending of this chapter of our lives. The trials and tribulations that were given to us were given for a reason, and has shaped and formed us into the future coaches, actors, lawyers, and activists. It gives me great assurance that if all of us put in effort to something we're passionate about, we're bound to achieve great things. Like J. Cole once said, follow your heart. Don't follow what you've been told you're supposed to do. Thank you, class of 2021.